A beautiful spring day in Tamaki Makaurau, and what a time to watch some basketball. It's been missing from our shores at the NBL level for most of this year, but we welcome it back tonight at Spark Arena on Auckland's wonderful waterfront. We've got influencers, both political and social media. We got television stars, we got warriors, we got All Blacks, and of course, we've got breakers. It's the Manuka Doctor Celeb Slam live from Spark Arena here on Sky Sport. And before the basketball gets underway, to the hardwood for a cultural performance. Entertainment has begun here at Spark Arena ahead of the Celebrity Slam. Team Tom against Team Finn here live on Sky Sport. Kia ora, Hugh Bannon here alongside me, multiple New Zealand NBL champion and all-star, and of course the Tall Black Centurion is Casey Frank. And Casey, how good is it to be back in the building?
How good is it to be in Spark? You feel the energy. It is a celebrity game, but I think the energy is even higher than you would have for a regular season opener for the Breakers. People are craving some hoops.
They absolutely are, and this is going to start, of course, as a bit of a preseason run out for the Breakers as well, who don't have much runs in their legs. But of course, there is a serious cause behind it, that of Starship. And you can donate following the link on the bottom of the page now, or by texting Celeb Slam at any time during the game, followed by your full name to 2838. All these players, no matter how much fun they're going to look like they're having tonight, believe me, they're taking it seriously whenever competitive hoops are on the line. Casey Frank, there was a draft and there was training.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. If it's worth playing, it's worth winning. And that goes for the Breakers and all the celebrities as well. A lot of athletes in there, but a lot of people are good at their field. And I guarantee you, none of them got into it because they didn't like winning. They all want to get this dub. They all want to be able to talk a little bit of smack afterwards, both in person, over drinks, and on social media afterwards. So look for some real effort to be put into the games today.
Absolutely. When there's this many people in the arena and watching at home, you are not going to take it lightly. To hear a little bit more about what's coming our way tonight, let's throw to the other end of the hardwood with Courtney Taiti, who's got Matt Walsh with us.
Well, Matt, congratulations on this event, the turnout, over 6,000 tickets, the celebrities. What does this event mean?
Yeah, this is just amazing. I mean, the fans who bought tickets, our partners, specifically Manuka Doctor and Matt Pringle. This, when we got this idea together, we thought, how could we give back to the community with some live sport, because we haven't had it here, and how could we do something really good for Starship? And with their support, we've been able to do this, and I think at the end of the night, everyone's going to be surprised at the size of the check we can write, and it's just awesome. That's what it's all about.
What did it mean to you and the Breakers franchise when all these celebrities put their hands up to take part tonight?
I have to be honest, I'm sorry for any celebrities watching at home that we said no to, because we didn't know we were going to get this kind of pickup. We have 32 celebrities here. They're the ones that drove all this. I'm so thankful for them, and I think we'll be back next year to do it again. So if you missed out this year, we'll get you back.
What does it mean to the Breakers community and the fans? You touched on it, but to have live basketball here in New Zealand and give back to the community.
God, it feels good. We haven't been here in 10 months. We wish it was an NBL game coming after this, but we're going to go over to Australia and kick some ass, and this is just amazing.
And who should we be keeping our eye on tonight for MVP? What's your pick?
All right, I'm going to go a little off the radar here, and I'm going to say Chloe Schwarbrick's going to be MVP.
Ooh. and up against David Seymour, no doubt. Well, Matt, we thank you for your time, and we congratulate you on this amazing event.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you, Courtney, and thank you, Matt. Yes, and for the MVP, you heard Matt Walsh's pick. Throughout the evening, you can go to the Breakers Instagram page and vote for who you think should be MVP tonight. And why don't we have a look at those rosters tonight, starting with Team Tom. First name I want to pull out in a semi-serious way, Casey Frank, is number zero, Ty Webster. We haven't seen him run out as a fully-fledged breaker since he was a development player. We're going to see him do it tonight.
Excited to see him back in New Zealand Breakers colors. He's excited to be back, although he's spending a lot of time in Australia. Glad to be in the homeland and enjoy a summer.
Now, number 11, Irene van Dijk, a legendary Silver Ferns shooter. Will that translate to the basketball?
Service says yes. That shooting translates everywhere. The way she can shoot the ball, as long as it's round, it's probably going to go in the hoop.
And number 9, of course, Guy Williams, so often seen sitting courtside at Breakers game. Let's not forget, Guy Williams is a former Wellington Saint, and the man can ball.
Well, first of all, I can't believe he's a Saint because he bleeds Nelson blue. So the fact that he went to Wellington shows you how much basketball he loves. Last time he played in a celebrity game, he tried to dunk on somebody and got denied. We'll see if that happens again.
Tom Abercrombie, the captain, and Finn Delaney, the captain of Team Finn. Delaney, Lowe, Webster, some good Breakers names there, of course. What about the flair Carlos Spencer's going to bring? Are we going to see some through-the-legs passes?
We're going to see a lot of things. I'm seeing some drop goals as well. If you can hit it from half court and earn that money for charity, that'll be great.
And the biggest influencer here tonight, of course, number 24 tonight, Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck, going up against his brother, Roger. It's going to be plenty of fun keeping an eye on Johnny tonight.
Well, he's looking like he's going to have a great time. He's certainly going to have an influence on the fun meter, if not the game.
Let's have a look at some of the more tantalizing matchups coming our way tonight. Why not start with an all-netball one, the veteran against Maya Wilson, 23 years old, against Irene van Dijk, 48.
Experience versus youth. You look at those Silver Fern caps there, both playing the goal shoot position. Excellent shooters, not too much difference in the size, but a few years between them. Let's see what matters most, that youthful exuberance or that experience.
That's like a head-to-head between you and me. And the other brothers, Roger against Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck. Instagram followers, Johnny wins. Rugby league career, that's Rogers.
I don't know which one would rather have which really at the moment, but looking at those Instagram followers, that's going to be pretty tough to beat him for MVP.
Absolutely, and switching codes to the 15-man code, Rugby Union, Liam Messam, legendary Chiefs player and a 43-time All Black against Carlos Spencer, one of the real flair players in the history of the game.
Well, just fantastic to have players of that caliber coming out and taking part in this for a good choice for charity. I'm excited to see this, but I'm most excited, I think, to see Carlos Spencer on the court. That's going to be fun.
And for the non-sports fan, potentially, David Seymour against Chloe Swarbrick, a parliamentary battle coming our way.
Certainly, we're leaning both sides of the aisle right here, far left, far right. And we've got two athletes on the court. One of them is a pretty good, decent basketball player. The other is David Seymour.
It's going to be a whole heap of fun. Let's not forget the matchup between Modi Mayor and Dan Shamir as well. They're going to be very competitive coaching these two times. Let's get the fun underway. Over to commentary with our own MVP, Andrew Mulligan.
Thank you very much, Hugh. Great to be back here at Spark Arena. And here is Team Tom and Team Finn going up against it in a unique All-Star Celeb Slam. Spark Arena, great to be back in here. We haven't been here since February. And on screen is Chris Johnson, the late ringer. He's played in the NBA as well. But here is Team Finn. And they're starting five. And they've used all their experience on hand of them. For them, and Finn Delaney and Corey Webster. Maya Wilson as well, who's played for the Tall Ferns as well as the Silver Ferns. Julian Savea, 2015 Rugby World Cup winner. And of course, he can ball as well. And Benny, who was here in Spark Arena a week or so ago, cleaning up at the AMAs. Right now, though, Finn Delaney is with Hugh Bainan.
Ben, you're looking just fantastic in your blue and pink, mate, and a slightly different event today, but you must be happy just to be back at Spark Arena.
Yeah, extremely excited to be back at Spark. It felt a little bit weird rolling in. It was like a real game, so it's going to be really cool.
Now, which of your teammates do we need to keep a special eye on today?
All of them, they're all looking good. No, seriously, everyone's there's going to be a lot of hidden talents out there, so we've been shooting around, practicing, and you know, everyone's nailing them, so I'm good.
It's all for a great cause, and you know Starship as well as anyone with your wonderful partner, Caitlin, working as a nurse there.
Yeah, she's a pediatric nurse there. She's actually been on night shifts the last few nights, so she's about to wake up and come on down, so we're excited.
You going to catch any bodies out there, maybe of some of your full-time Breakers teammates?
Might have to.
Best of luck. Thanks, mate.
That will be exciting. That duo there will be exciting for Tom Abercrombie starting five. Jared Weeks and Ty Webbs are the two guards for the Breakers. Aaron Fantai, 145 test matches for New Zealand. Roger Tuivasa-Sheck, a 2018 Dalian winner. And Chris Mack, one of the biggest bands in New Zealand, if not the biggest, over the last 20 or so years. Tom Abercrombie spoke with you earlier on.
Tom, it's been a long time between basketball drinks. You must be hanging out together on the hardwood again.
Yeah, man, it's good to be back here. It's been a long time since we've been in Spark Arena, and awesome to be back and really excited to get going.
Not your usual game of basketball. Your team, Team Tom, which teammates are we looking out for?
There's a range of talent in there. Roger's been at nearly every practice session. He's been looking good, but Guy Williams has come in late in the piece and certainly backed himself. So, hey, we'll wait and see when we throw it out there.
Of course, it's all for a fantastic course. Starship, of course, very close to your heart as well.
Yeah, no, I've spent a bit of time in there with some of my kids, so it's amazing charity to be raising money for today. They do amazing things for a lot of children, and awesome to be giving back to them in some way.
Talk us through your shoes on that note.
Yeah, man, I got these Under Armour shoes, inspired by the nurses' uniforms at Starship. They've got the colours there which represent the different floors at Starship, and a little nod to all my kids in there. We're going to auction these off during / after the game, and all the money raised is going straight to Starship as well, so someone's going to be very lucky.
Absolutely. Thanks, Tom. Best of luck.
Right, let's just get this game underway. Casey Frank. And it's an absolute stitch-up on the tip-off with Aaron Fantai up against the diminutive Benny. Crowd are on their feet. Spark Arena is loud. Let's get this game underway. Straight away. It's Tom West dropped the back ball to Tom Abercrombie.
And now some struggle in the defensive transition.
Finn is leaked down and he gives it a windmill.
At least to start the day, pulling no punches in the dunk contest.
Ty Webster on the baseline. Aaron Van Dyke's foul. Three shots coming for Aaron Fantai.
What number? 91 and 3 shots.
Foul call pretty early. Referee Dallas Pickering. I've seen him make many a bad call, but I'll give him the break on that one.
We are 23 seconds into the game, and Casey is bagging the referee.
Three shots.
Don't call fouls in this league, pretty good. What's going on here?
Aaron Van Dyke.
Stroke.
No. Quite far out from the hoop where she normally shot in an international netball career. Still has that form, though.
I'm still waiting for the netballer who gets the skill from 15 feet and just starts bobbing away like that at 90%. Looks like she could have been a forebearer.
All right. Ball is live. One shot.
And third shot for Aaron Van Dyke. Good. As well, so 2 of 3, pretty good for Aaron Fantai. Won the world champs with the Silver Ferns in 2003. Corey Webster with the ball, thought about it from the logo.
Remember, the logos are worth more. You got the extra points from shooting out there.
Brother Ty went for it, Corey for four. And it's Roger Tuivasa-Sheck with the rebound, shattered by Julian Savier. The crossover, back of the iron, and it's the bus with the ball. Goes around Van Dyke, step through, knocked away. Whoa, a bit of defense, Case.
A lot of defense. I like the hands going in. You see the effort out there. They're getting back a little bit after the first start. A little bit of effort going on out there.
Ty Webster misses, but the putback is good.
Last work. Getting two.
Benny with the ball.
This is the most I've seen Corey Webster the past start again. Unfortunately.
Ah, the follow by Delaney. Unlucky for Julian Savier.
But Delaney always there to pick it up.
Tom for four. Chris Mack.
Oh, good look, good pass. Boards all day.
And for Julian Savier. Was I going to let Tom get an easy one?
And one thing I'll tell everybody on Team Tom, just preempting for when James McConey comes into the game, do not go up for a dunk when he's around you because he'll try and take you down. As we see, Finn Delaney with the timing on the glass.
We had the privilege of playing the Youth Town charity game, Casey Frank, many years ago now, and you were on a breakaway. You were going to throw him down, and James McConey really hustled back and got you.
Yeah, he tried to murder me. I filed assault charges. The police took it seriously, but I decided to drop him eventually because he's a good dude.
Eight, four is the score.
Deep balls. It's tough from the logo. I feel like if the logo wasn't there, the guys would be shooting a little bit more smoothly. Right now, Team Tom getting it done offensively and happy to give up those deep shots from the logos.
Benny's on Tom. Tom and those special underarmers up to tie. It wasn't quite timed. These Breakers players, they've been playing mostly 4-on-4 scrimmages. Every now and again, they call up some extra players. But they are desperate to play some competitive basketball. Maya Wilson with the fake.
Oh.
Missed the reverse.
All the work. Couldn't get the finish, but lovely footwork along the baseline to get there. It's Benet.
Go,
the
Benny.
Steal and the break.
Benny, Benny.
What she got? Get it in there.
Oh. Just to the left. Good hustle from Webster. Ty Webster has it now. Webster pulls up. Yeah, Ty Webster for four.
From deep, Team Tom keeps it going.
Corey Webster is standing on the Manuka Doctor logo waiting for a pass. And Ty Webster has been active. He gives it to Corey. Here it comes. Chris Mack is not going to let him have a piece of that.
Look at the shoulder deep.
That's some Chris Golding-like defense on Corey Webster. Finn Delaney, too strong. Here comes Tui Vasashek. That first step is so quick.
He's coming through with the quickness and the finger roll. It's pretty. It's so pretty.
The Breakers are about to do what the Warriors did in the NRL season. Go to Australia in the middle of December. It's Delaney. Puts the layup in. Roger Tui Vasashek almost got dunked on, and Finn Delaney was a gentleman about it.
I'd like to see the dunks go. If you're going to be a breaker, you're going to have to dunk everything you're finishing. Just like that, Ty Webster, showing off that athleticism that Breakers fans on both sides of the ditch are excited to see in a Breakers uniform with his defensive prowess coming to the forefront. As you see the replay, drive down the baseline and smashes it home. Fly high, young Webster.
The lead is double figures already, so we've got a timeout. Modi Moa, assistant coach of the Breakers.
Guy Williams giving it to his teammates. Jared Weeks, he wasn't even in the game yet.
He wasn't. He was in that starting five list, but he isn't on the court. Roger Tui Vasashek and Johnny Tui Vasashek. Looking forward to those brothers matching up. Johnny has already made use of having a Vivid, and he's got everyone to sign his jersey, which is a great move. What a unique experience for these guys and girls.
Definitely want to do that early instead of late. After the game, everybody gets lost. You do it beforehand, you know you got it. And I'll tell you what, he was putting on some quality celebrations just in warm-up. So I'm excited to see if he actually gets anything done once he gets on the court.
If you catch him on Instagram or Facebook, you see those day one fans you were talking about with the NBA, loves a shooting sleeve.
You got to have the shooting sleeve. You can't be a player without a shooting sleeve.
Chris Johnson, the late ring, and he's 35 years old. He's played around the NBA. The Hornets, the T-Wolves, the Celtics, the Trailblazers from LSU with his college career.
Not a bad guy to pick up. He's good old Team Tom.
Close. Swarbrick couldn't quite get it from Ruby Tui.
Good luck, Ruby Tui, using those seven skills to great effect there. Finding Chloe Swarbrick on the break. Just couldn't quite grab it.
Number six hunger is Liam Messam, who has had an exceptional rugby career. Jenny May Coffin over Rob Lowe. Rob Lowe with the outlet. Chloe Swarbrick chases it down. Jared Weeks. She's not afraid to shoot.
She takes her shot. We saw that in the election.
Here's Carlos Spencer. Swarbrick again. Yeah. Courtney, who you got?
Maya Wilson and Benny with me, two of the superstars that started for Team Finn. Maya, how was it out there?
I really don't know what's up with this reffing. Some of these fouls are pretty foul themselves, and I think we should be getting some more free shots on that free throw.
Benny, what are your thoughts on the game? How do you get back into this one?
Shoot some goals, baby!
Maya, who do you need to shut down on the other team? I mean, RTS, he was going pretty hard out there.
Oh, he's going hundies. Like, you would think we're playing league or something, but, you know, once we get some decent defence on them, we'll be all right.
All right. Well, you heard it here from Team Penn. They're ready to get back out there. Rockstars.
Thanks, Courtney. And Rob Lowe plays spoiler, knocks the free throw off the rim, which he can do. And Carla Spencer with the ball now. Jenny May Coffin happy to play defense on him. Is Ruby Tilley.
Let's it fly. Just a bit long.
This is Chris Johnson.
Corey Swarbrick playing the good D. Rob Lowe, you got a dunk?
Oh, my.
He has been in the weight room this offseason.
Push and shove between Jared Weeks and Rob Lowe. Rob Lowe, he'll be going to Australia a little bit later on. Expecting the birth of his child in January.
He's pumped up for it. Mostly scared because all the other fathers of the basketball community and tell them what to be aware of.
Corey from deep. Johnson. He has a wingspan. It's Chris Johnson. My goodness.
Is long.
Great look from Guy Williams. Rob Lowe with the block. Here comes Carlos Spencer.
Hey, what a great vision by Rob Lowe to find the streaking Carlos Spencer. Looked like he was back on the wing of a different kind with that finish.
Good pass, but turned over, stripped by Corey Webster. There is so much going on as Liam Messam just picks up Corey Webster. They're going to let that one slide. Johnny Tuivasa ready to check in. Just Johnny. Finn just giving him some advice.
Just let him know who to check in. He said, go get Corey Webster. If he has not hit a shot, get out of there. We see the replay of the beautiful block by Rob Lowe. You see the ball coming in. Oh, off the foot of Corey Swarbrick, unfortunately.
Unlucky with that. Johnson to Williams. Liam Messam. Finished playing for Waikato in the Mitre 10 Cup. Jenny May gets it. Chris Johnson.
Smashing the offensive glass now.
Johnson again. Ruby Tilley. Rob Lowe relishing playing up high. Stifling defense from Guy Williams.
Passing the post there.
It's that shooting sleeve just giving him too much. Chris Johnson's relishing playing up high as well.
Oh, the steal.
Here comes Rob Lowe. Can we get another dunk?
Ruby Tui is psyched, and why not? Gets the steal, ignites the break. Rob Lowe with the finish, but he did none of the work. It was all Ruby Tui.
Guy Williams.
Get it out. Bad call. That was clean.
That was clean from Ruby Tilley. She tells the referee.
Guy Williams thought he had his dunk. He's been talking it up. He wants this dunk badly. Badly he wants it.
As you can see, Guy he's mic'd up. And if you've played against Guy Williams around Auckland, he has a lot to say. I'm not surprise. Talking about on stage, I'm talking about on court. He banked that free throw in.
That was horrific.
Absolutely beautiful. Don't worry about that, Guy.
That was not supposed to be a bank shot. I'm so sorry. This one's you, Mum.
Oh, kissed at home. I guess he doesn't love his mum. He missed that one.
And he fires it out. Carl Spencer waiting for it.
Good thought. It was tricky. If executed not to perfection.
Jared Weeks steps into a four. Front of the iron, another rebound for Rob Lowe.
got the 3-on-4 break here. What do they got? Carlos Spencer trying to pull out the tricks. Just goes with the easy dish. Ruby Tui.
Ruby Tui finds low. Low for four. Low knocks that down.
Cuts it back to a one-point lead. Big shot there by Big Rob Lowe.
Now his guy, Williams, powers through.
Guy Williams feels good about that one. He has got his eyes set on that MVP. He wants everybody on the gram to give him a vote. Remember, don't forget, when you're shooting from the Manuka Doctor insignias, those are four-pointers. Watch out, up below!
Oh, they missed him off the backboard of Chris Johnson.
Second off the glass alley-oop of the day. The over-under was 3, so we're almost there.
Ruby Tui, front of the iron. Chris Johnson returns the favor to Messon.
Oh, good luck on the break. Just couldn't get the feet down.
JTS with the ball. Guy Williams read that play. Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck. He has a lot to say to referee Pickering.
I'm with the players. The refs are doing a bad job.
Sporadic amounts of defense played in various parts of the floor, but here is Messon to Johnson off the backboard.
Beautiful, beautiful athleticism on display there. As we have a timeout to one of the teams, I'm not sure which, but it doesn't really matter.
Doesn't matter. But I tell you what, with a minute 42 to go in this first quarter, it is above expectations. It is a lot of fun. And they're running some plays. Albeit, albeit 4-point plays, but they're running plays.
Yeah, it's a lot of looks for the deep shot. That's true. But as it gets along, I think once we get towards the dearth of the game, towards the end, we're going to see defense get a little bit tighter, everybody take a little bit more seriously. It's all fun and games now. But everybody wants to win, regardless what you're doing. Like I said, if it's worth playing, it's definitely worth winning.
The All-Star Celeb Slam at Spark Arena on the floor. Coming out by the looks of things might be a Shane Young, Kai Kara of France, double act UFC combo. And that is how you can donate to Starship, this fundraiser. Tom Abercrombie and his wife Monique, all too familiar with the brilliant people that work at Starship. And Tom honoring those who work at Starship with those shoes tonight. Nick Mowbray. Mowbray is out there for Zuru. Tane Murray, who's off to the University of Virginia the season after next.
Taking a little bit more time than the COVID-free New Zealand before he heads to that well-known COVID hotspot called America.
Certainly. And Greg Murphy, four-time Bathurst winner and close personal friend of Marcus Ambrose, is now on the floor as well. Guy Williams back at the line. All right, let's go back to Courtney Taiti.
Far out, not more free throws.
Well, here's two people that you definitely wouldn't want to be up against, Liam Mess and Roger Tuivasa-Sheck. How is it out there?
That's pretty fast. It's pretty cool, though. Enjoying it.
And I see you guys are bringing some skill to it all, but who do you need to shut down on the other team?
Man, I think the Breakers boys are killing it, eh? So just got to watch out for them. Corey, I know he wants to pick it up real bad, so watch out for Corey.
And I saw in training you two gave it to your brother, Johnny. Are you going to see more of that tonight? Give it to Johnny, give him a hard time?
Yeah, for sure. He's been hyping up the most, so I'm keen to shut him down.
Haven't even seen him tonight.
Yeah.
Where is he?
Oh, talk there, dude.
Well, you heard it here from Team Tom. There's a bit of smack talk here, but I'll let the boys get back out to it.
Good stuff. Thanks, Court.
Where is he? Shots fired. Oh, Nick Mowbray, we're going all the way to the hole. Oh, did all the work. Couldn't get the finish.
Nuri is out there. So is Zoe Sadowski-Sinnott. Olympic winter Olympic medalist. And Tane Murray for four. Guy Williams taking his time. Legs might not be quite under Guy Williams at the moment. He's lost his mic pack. Needs a sub. Audio, can they please go to the sideline and sort Guy Williams's mic pack out, please? Shane Young's in trouble with the ball. Ruby Tui is
hustling and does a cartwheel.
She the athlete. Look at the locked in defensive efforts all over the place and just finish it off with a cartwheel. Why not? Strain my back just looking at it.
Ty Webster to Nuri. Kai Kara France, he's been putting in the work on the floor. Nick Mowbray showing with the left. Couldn't quite get the handle. Modi Moa, what an intentional foul.
He doesn't even know he got fouled. He's going for it. No breaks.
Sinek Mowbray at the line, and of course Runzo Zuru, one of the sponsors, and if you're into water balloons, Nick is your man.
Trains the first free throw. He's looking locked in. You can tell he's taking it pretty seriously when he's running down for the break. He's looking to get some buckets. Not that one, though. Easy on the backboard.
Kai Kara France gets the layup. Kai Kara, the USC flyweight.
Oh, leaks out to get the break.
From City Kickboxing, Rob Lowe gets... He's just feasting, Rob Lowe. He's just taking absolute full advantage of his height. He's got 12 points from 4 of 4 shooting.
Rob Lowe like a hungry man at the buffet. He going to eat. And he is feeding.
Ty Webster nails the 4. The honeypot shot is good.
4 points from the honeypot. Ty Webster throwing off that range that has Breakers fans excited for this season.
That gives Team Tom a 6-point lead.
Nothing but net. That stroke is pure.
That was to close out the first quarter as well. Team Tom with that 6-point lead. 27-21.
Was that only one quarter worth of action?
It certainly was.
Unbelievable. A great start. Both teams coming out playing hard and a lot of enthusiasm. Looking to see both teams go a little bit deeper into the bench.
James McConey on screen. Looking forward to seeing my old mate from Crowd Goes Wild get on the floor. He was 50-50 today. He was DNP CD potential as well. But he is on the bench, still waiting for a call-up from Modi.
He's going to get it soon. Oh, he's got the headband on, though. That looks official now.
Now we got some musical cheers going on. Oh, is that Glenn Rice Jr.'s jersey out there with Cheeky the Kid?
Glenn Rice Jr.?
Isn't that the old Cheeky the Kid? He's just pushed a kid. He's pushed a kid off a chair.
Did he come back?
That is
just to push kids around.
The ultimate Cheeky the Kid. I love the fact he's wearing a Glenn Rice Jr. singlet as well. The irony is not lost on any Breakers fans. And now we've got 2 cheers, 2 kids, and a giant bird playing out for musical cheers.
Oh, it's getting tight on the... Oh, pushes another kid around.
Another kid out of the way. This is poor form from Cheeky the Kia.
Glenn Rice Jr. Cheeky. I'm telling you what, wait a minute, we've got another Cheeky the Kia coming on the court.
Here's the real Cheeky the Kia.
What is going on?
That Cheeky the Kia is standing up for the kids. Oh, he's going to take a hit off.
This is looking violent.
This is looking no good. I wonder who is in that old Cheeky the Kia outfit there on the left of the screen in the Glenn Rice Jr. number 41 singlet.
Who's who? Why are there 2 Cheekies?
And the music has stopped. And Cheeky the Kia can't quite get it. Oh, Cheeky loses. Whoever that kid is, he's done a wonderful job. Rob Lowe's out there to celebrate.
And the Kias are going at it. Spider-Man's trying to break things up, but I don't think he's got actual superpowers, so it's getting difficult.
Guys, please.
Managed to separate the birds.
Finn, what are we going to do?
Well, those birds of a feather do flock together. Wait a minute. Who is it? Who is in there?
Is that Joseph Parker? Joseph Parker was down to play, but he had more fun in the Cheek of the Care costume. Oh, it's just time for a sweet photo as well with the champ. His fights postponed with Junior Farr and Joseph Parker having fun. Joseph.
Well, that was a surprise. I did not expect Joseph Parker to be in there.
I did not see that coming. Are you interested in stats? Because we have some for you.
There's the stats. Tough times from three. The four-pointer looking okay for Team Tom. Not so much for Team Finn. Rebounds, Team Tom. Assists, Team Finn. So back and forth affair, hence the six-point score difference.
I get the second quarter underway. Eric Murray is out there, two-time Olympic gold medalist with the Kiwi pair with Hamish Bond. And I believe his number is 71-0, and that is the unbeaten run that those two enjoyed in that boat. That is impressive.
That's not bad. I mean, you could have gone 72 maybe, but 71's
not. Yeah, there's a basketball ring about it. James McCody is out there in the second quarter as well. Mowbray Malele as well. Sadowski Sinnott, Kaikara France, Shane Young, oh, wow. Ty Webster, and Nuri.
Team Finn still struggling from the four-point honeypot. The Manuka Doctor sponsored shot. Oh, nutmeg through the legs of Eric Murray.
A little strong on that jumper, but Eric Murray has it. Nick Mowbray only knows one way.
Hard. Full speed.
Tries to cross over.
And he's pumped. He doesn't even know he got fouled. He's just back on D trying to hustle back. Gets the end one. He is focused. He is, look at him. Dribbling around, eyes down like Bob Cousy back in the 50s. Does not matter though. Gets the finish, takes the contact, drops it through the net. Team Finn's pumped to get back closer to the game.
Some real bad boys Pistons defense from Nuri there. Just an absolute body check. No, Mowbray's back at the line. And he misses the and one opportunity, but it's Eric Murray to Finn Delaney. And so Team Finn now closes the gap to two.
And the offensive rebounds have seemed to be a bit of a key today. Not a lot of boxing out going on.
Shane Young too strong. James McCony, look out. Runaway try.
All the way.
Oh, can't get the roll. And he's got the foul call, though. James McCony will go to the line.
Officiating crew giving.
Shout out to James wearing the Victor Oladipo jersey as well. The name on the back.
Is he a big Indiana Pacers fan?
He loves Victor Oladipo.
Just him.
Do the Indiana Pacers love Victor Oladipo, though?
Not really.
But he is, of course, now a part owner of the Sky Sport New Zealand Breakers. Tony couldn't bank it in.
Oh, good outlet there.
Great pass. Kaikara France misses that. Malele gets it. All right, Courtney, who do you have?
Well, we saw the activation with musical chairs. We saw someone very cheeky, but we didn't realise behind it all was Joseph Parker. Joe, how was it being out there on court taking on the little children?
I'll tell you this, I had to cheat my way to win, and I didn't win, so it was good to be out there, to be involved, but I guess it wasn't my day today.
And how incredible is it to have the turnout, the celebrities, but also the fans, and have some sport here in New Zealand?
It's so awesome. If you are, like I said, if you look around here, the support that's here, the crowd, the energy, but also all the, you know, the people that are involved in playing. Everyone came together to make it happen, and it's great to have an event like this in New Zealand.
And what was it, your reaction like when you got asked to be part of it? I know a lot of the celebs put their hands up straight away to help support a great cause.
I'm actually very honoured that they called me and gave me the opportunity to be a part of it. I know a lot of people wanted to play and be a part of it, but we're the lucky ones who got to be chosen. So it's great to support a great cause like Starship.
And have you ever been in a mascot costume like this before?
This is my first time. It's probably my last.
Well, hey, you heard it. You heard it here first. This is the first and last time you'll see Joe Parker dressed up as a mascot.
You got it.
As we see Eric Murray take it up. Half-court shot. Remember, a half-court shot make is $10,000 to start shit.
That is on. Ty Webster was just actually trying his form from halfway as those foul shots were being taken. And Kaikara France left wide open. Ooh. Knocks down the two. It was a long two.
front of the line, but the stroke looked good from three. Just got to take that half step back to get it going.
Delaney looking for somebody. Mowbray steals it.
Steals it from his own teammate.
From his own teammate.
He is thirsty for points.
It's Kaikara. Oh, he gets the two from Delaney. Too late on the help.
Back to back. The shortest man on the court right now. His game is tall with these buckets.
Jared Weeks came out and told Finn Delaney about it, but Delaney now goes for four. Webster in the corner, who I believe hasn't checked in the game yet.
Just let it fly anyway.
He's a shooter effort. Even from the bench.
He's definitely not passing it from out of bounds. So could have let that one fly. There's just some mass substitutions out there.
David Seymour's on the floor. He is a tough act to follow, David Seymour. And, of course, Chloe Swarbrick is out there now. Left and right, about to go at it.
Who's she checking in for? Somebody's got to come out. We got six players. Finn Delaney.
Finn Delaney's been subbed.
Well, he doesn't like it, but he takes it.
There are no professional basketball players on the floor for Team Finn. Julian Savio on Ty Webster. Seymour with the ball. Seymour. Travel.
Went with the... That would have been a heck of a fake. If you could pull off that move, you'd be pretty good.
How quickly did they close in on David Seymour?
It looks like a defense focus. Trying to get these guys.
Back to the action. And Julian Savio has it now. David Seymour proves no opposition. And it's taken by Chris Johnson with those long arms. And Chris Johnson leisurely takes it up. Notley gives it up to Seymour. Benny's all over him. Here comes Julian Savio. Ty Webster in the passing lanes.
The save. Seymour with the falcon.
It's an absolute falcon from David Seymour. Ty Webster up ahead to Johnson.
Watch out. Going up.
Johnson with the slam.
Always good to get the seven-footers coming through for the finishes.
Savio steps through. He's got a little euro on him.
Ooh, lovely step.
Consider he's coming back from France. This little move from
there
Julian Savio.
I see what you did there, and I like this.
Only the second quarter case. I'm tapped out. Johnson. Finn Delaney gets the board, gives it to Chloe Swarbrick. I tell you what, Chris Mack is proving that this is no just exhibition game.
Oh, David Seymour with his chance.
Here's Delaney's going to block it. Oh, he's going to fake. Oh, yeah.
Counted as an assist. David Seymour with the lob. Ty Webster with the finish. Just great to see the enthusiasm of the fans and the players on court as Finn Delaney hits the four-pointer from the Manuka Honey Pot to bring his team a wee bit closer.
Chris Mack, maybe a carry. Finn Delaney almost swipes it. Ty Webster with the look away to Johnson, and Johnson with another dunk.
Too easy with that kind of length underneath the rim. Now, as Eric Murray gets it stolen by Johnson from behind. Chris Mack, offensive rebound. Finn Delaney with the block, though, so denied.
Goes through Chris Mack's legs to Delaney. Benny back to Finn Delaney. Gets Ty Webster up. Can he bank it in? And no, it's Savio with the ball. Swarbrick, she can't get it to go off the glass. Up to David Seymour. David Seymour. Did he travel? He got fouled. And it counts. Unbelievable. David Seymour.
His team is going crazy. Nobody expected this level of athleticism from David Seymour. Whoa, and one. Bene with the foul. Looked like a lot of ball. Might have been another bad call, but David Seymour will go to the line regardless, and he is pumped.
Oh, the timeout is called. The skin of the pink women.
Team Tom with a 10-point lead. David Seymour, the axe party leader, proving the entertainment in the second quarter. Timeout called. with 5:12 to go in this first half at Spark Arena. And given the success of this game so far, this should be an annual thing.
You get what I mean? This is our house, is what I mean. All right. We need to take the ball hard to the wing. Then Chris, you come to the centre, get the pass. When the pass goes to Chris, Nori's going to flash high. We hit Nori. Nori out to Tom. Tom, Elliot, David, Duncan. Dunk the ball. We need dunks. Here we go, here we go.
On the ball, according to Casey Frank.
That is the exact opposite of what I said.
One shot. One.
They're going to have to replace the backboards after this game, I'm thinking.
Not a long life for this.
Someone needs to call, like, Novus or something. Here's Eric Murray. Oh, Eric Murray glides in with a finger roll.
Floater game. It's pretty. Toss it up high, finish low.
Abercrombie for four.
Hidden from the Manuka Doctor, Honey Pot. Thomas Abercrombie makes it look easy.
Chris Mack is a terrier in the backcourt as they try to bring that ball up. Julian Savia.
Savia almost gets the foul there on David Seymour.
Abercrombie with the long miss. Here's Savia. Gets the layup.
Fearless right at the seven-footer for the finish.
Savia tried to reverse. Chris Johnson was going to hit another one.
Lovely bit of touch zone there, though.
Seymour hounded by Corey Webster and stripped.
Corey Webster. Apparently leaning the other direction politically because he took that one right out of the hands of Pete Swarbrick.
Front of the rim this time for Chloe. The MP for Auckland Central, Chris Mack. Their 660 film debuting tonight in theatres. And Courtney Taiti has Kai Kara France with her.
I do, Miles. Well, Kai, the team is up, but you scored a three. You're telling me it's your first three ever, but I don't think it is.
I haven't played since I was an intermediate, eh? So I guess what a time to shine. My basketball debut down at the Breakers, I was just telling you before, last time I was in the stadium was when I fought February UFC Auckland, so surreal to be here. It's like awesome turnout for a great cause, Starship.
A very great cause. What does it mean for you to be supporting the cause, but also be supporting it amongst other celebrities?
It's amazing, you know. We all come from different codes and all here for a great cause, and just being out and entertaining with our friends and family again, it's just a nice way to end the year.
And what was the feeling like when the crowd cheered for you?
Brought me back memories of me getting a finish in the UFC, so I think I need one of them because I haven't got one in a while. But Breakers, if you need a point guard, you're looking at it.
Breakers, he's right here, your next point guard, Kai Kara France.
5'5".
Kai Kara France is an absolute weapon. Don't let his height fool you. His nickname is Don't Blink.
It's not the size of the dog in the fight, it's the size of the fight in the dog.
100%. I know that City Kickboxing team captain Dan the Hangman Hooker understandably upset that they took the two shortest guys from City Kickboxing and Shane Young and Kai Kara France to this game. And now we've got multiple changes for both teams. Maya Wilson's back on the floor with Ruby Tui and Carlos Spencer for Team Finn. Jared Weeks is out there. David Seymour, very hard to pull off on the right-hand side of the floor. And so for Team Tom, Roger Tuivasa-Sheck, Irene van Dijk and Jenny Mae Clarkson, two Silver Ferns out there. There's Ruby Tui with the ball.
Oh, calm plays. She's out there trying to get the motion going.
Tui for four. Webster trying to put it back up and in. Carlos Spencer can't get the follow-up. J-May with the behind-the-back pass.
Oh, it's pretty.
And J-May for four. It's in! Jenny Mae
Houston absolutely drills it. Showing the range and let the crowd know she's hyped. She's going to give fives to everybody.
How good. That is so awesome. Look at this from Jenny Mae Clarkson, the former Silver Fern. She knew it was good when it left her hands.
Hyped about it. Look at that fire. That is pumped. That one's going on the highlight reel.
Another timeout with a minute 25 to go in this first half. We've had a lot of things in this game. There's a lot to unpack in the first half.
Hey, way to go, David. Way to battle, bro. Way to battle. Way to battle. Jenny.
Seven plays 35. It's under a minute and a half to go in the first half of the Manuka Doctor All-Star Celeb Slam. Maya Wilson, Carlos Spencer, Ruby Tui, Rob Lowe, and Corey Webster with J May, Jared Weeks, Roger Tui Vasa Sheck, Aaron Van Dyke, and Nolly out there. And we are good to go when Aaron Van Dyke inbounds the ball to Roger Tui Vasa Sheck. I don't think I thought I'd ever say that in 2020, to be honest, Casey Frank.
That was difficult to find as we see the half corner.
Jared Weeks for 10K!
How about that?
Jared Weeks from way downtown.
The half quarter turning cash for charity.
Lowe tries to answer. Back to Corey Webster. It's not backcourt. It's a charity game.
The rules don't apply except for 1,000 points.
Oh, swats it out of there to Rob Lowe. What a bully.
Rob Lowe. As we see the Jared Weeks half quarter splash. Nothing but the bottom of the net. He drinks deeply from the zone and lets the basketball go. Let's go.
Now we're having discussions of whether or not it was behind the line.
It has to be behind the line at half court. And it was close. We're going to have to look at that replay.
Maybe we
half court again
to review it.
One more replay when we got a chance at some action. We see the break going through. Ball goes out of bounds.
Maya Wilson just had not to let that easy bucket go.
Is his foot from behind the half court? His foot is on the line.
Oh. Still discussions going on whether or not that Weeks half court shot should be allowed, and Maya Wilson with the bucket. Seconds to go in the game. Jared Weeks again. Missed it to the right. Carlos Spencer quickly to the ball. 15 seconds to go.
He's good at the changeover. 15 seconds. What are they going to do? Rob Lowe going for another half quarter.
Rob Lowe. That's not back over.
Back forth. Back again.
Rob Lowe again.
And time is up.
That is us for the first half at Spark Arena. A unique evening between two teams led by Tom Abercrombie and Finn Delaney. We've got more basketball coming up shortly. I hope you enjoyed the first half. It was highly entertaining. More of that is coming up soon.
Makoto, Auckland, it really does have it all. You're never far from world-class shopping, dining, or beaches when you're in Aotearoa's biggest city. And tonight, We're not far from some entertaining basketball here at our premier indoor sports arena. It is, of course, Spark Arena on Auckland's sparkling waterfront, where Team Tom lead Team Finn 50 points to 37 at halftime. Kia ora, Hugh Bannon here alongside Casey Frank. And Casey, we have been highly entertained, and many a dollar has been raised in the first half of basketball tonight.
Well, we've seen a lot of effort out there, both teams playing hard. Execution maybe not exactly where you want to be, but man, those guys are going for those four-pointers especially.
Every now and then in life, there's one of those really annoying people who's really good at everything. And how about Sky Sports' very own Ruby Tui? Let's have a look at some of her highlights, Case.
Well, she's out there putting in the effort. We're showing some great, fantastic defensive instincts, kicking the ball ahead for the teammates as well, creating on both sides, and fired up an emotional touch point for the 4-14 Finn and getting the feet over. Maybe it's a kick some of the time, but the cartwheel to finish off, fantastic to see that kind of enthusiasm out there on the court.
I'll just clarify, I don't find Ruby annoying. I think Ruby's fantastic.
Too late, mate, too late.
What about this matchup, David Seymour and Benny?
I like the fire, I like it. David Seymour out there, everybody's gunning for him. He's still getting him up. Benny wasn't having it, though. She's looking for her teammates. She's not stepping back. That looked clean to me. Bad call by the ref. I thought it was a travel. David Seymour got an N1. She's got a bone to pick in the second half.
Oh, Benny representing young people everywhere by really taking it to David Seymour. What about, potentially, the player of the game so far, Jenny May Clark?
Fantastic no look there. But then to the four-pointer. Hits the four, and the celebration was
that.
As good as everything else. Fantastic effort by her.
Jenny, mate, the celebration of the day so far. Let's go see what's going on elsewhere with Courtney Taiti.
Well, I've found Storm Purvis straight from the crowd goes wildest, straight to the court side. Storm, how great is this atmosphere?
I cannot get over the atmosphere. Oh my God, I wasn't expecting there to be this many people here. It's absolutely amazing. Not going to lie, I have got the best seats in the house.
She does, right there, court side.
All the action, it's awesome.
Now, Andrew Mulligan, James McConey, we stole them from crowd to do this game. McConey's been out on the court. What are your thoughts on his game?
Well, I was a little bit late because I was at crowd, but I did manage to see him on defense down this end, and I think he got a rebound, so pretty good from him. We've heard him talk about his sore knee, so if he complains about it tomorrow, I don't want to hear about it. Just get in there and have fun, mate.
And Jenny May got a four-point shot.
Amazing. So what's that? $4,000, is it?
Yeah, we'll take it. But hey, all for a good cause, but great to see Storm here with the rest of the crowd goes wild. True.
Thanks, Courtney. Great to see Storm down here. The halftime entertainment continues. Team Tom lead Team Finn 50 points to 39. Do not forget to donate using the links at the bottom of your page right there. More basketball coming up here from Spark Arena after the break.
Welcome back to Spark Arena, an entertainment extravaganza of the first half. I'm not overstating that. There was a lot of highlights to pack in from our halftime show, and they've really packed in at Spark Arena as well. They have been starved of basketball at the NBL level, and the Breakers have put this on because they have to head to Australia. They can't thank their fans enough for coming out tonight before they head across to the ditch in a few weeks' time, and that's when they'll base for who knows for how long, as we saw the Warriors have to do it in the NRL. Those are the stats. Make of them what you will.
They're very meaningful. Nobody shooting the four-pointing well or the three-pointer, but we're seeing decent glass, good assist numbers there. A lot more steals than I expected, the defensive effort.
Now, just to update you on that half-court shot, Jared Weeks' foot was over the line, just though, but if there is no half-court shot hit for the rest of the game, they will honour that Jared Weeks one.
Okay.
And they don't want the players to stop taking it.
I like it. It doesn't count unless it counts. Let's roll with that.
As the teams file on. Back to get a bit of warm-up in. And I tell you what, there's a few red faces, even though they've had a substantial break of about 8 minutes or so. They've really put it on there. As someone just missed a half-court shot to win some Burger King money of $4,000.
The half-court shots are coming thick and fast as James McConey comes over to just say hi.
James McConey on the third mic, on the backup mic, just letting the audio know. How you going, man?
Not well. pulled my hammy in the first play that I did. Terrible finger roll that never dropped for me. Gutted.
Have you done a hammy now?
I've done a hammy.
You got a knee, you got a calf, a knee, and now a hammy.
It's almost like you didn't train for this.
Look, I came in with a lot of things, all right? That's the whole point. I was a massive liability.
Okay, well,
they knew about that.
We have to go to Modi Mawar now. He's with Hugh Bainan.
Let's go to Modi.
Thanks, Andrew. I've got both the coaches here, and one happier than the other. Up 50 points. Dan, you're winning. You must be feeling good back at Spark Arena.
It's amazing to be here. But you see the work we did on offense, okay? Those 50 points are a lot of preseason work.
You get a chance to go up against the boss. You're down, Modi. What's happening?
I feel very bad. Lucky on my side, I got the leader, Chloe. She took care of the locker room in there, and I think we're going to come out with new energy.
For probably the last time in 2020, Dan, what was the message at halftime?
Stay humble, keep working hard and together, and let's get this W.
I've never seen Dan Shamir smiling so much at halftime. Back to you, Andrew.
That's the exact same message you give us, Hugh, before every game.
Stay humble?
Yeah. It's incredible.
It's amazing he doesn't take it himself, though.
It's loud in Spark Arena. It's gone quiet for just a moment. It's about to ramp back up. Guy Williams, we've taken the mic off him.
Were there complaints?
Well, I think he wore it out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. No complaints. Of course, no complaints.
No complaints for the enthusiasm being shown today.
Looking forward to seeing these teams try these half-court shots. Of course, Kaikara France hit one in training. That was worth $5,000. Matt Walsh put $5,000 on the line saying, anyone who could hit it before me, $5,000 goes to charity, to Starship. You can vote for your MVP on Instagram as well. Just tag in the Breakers account, and you can choose who your MVP is. It might be the next person that had a half-court shot.
There you go. That would be the real MVP. Anybody who's getting funds for Starship, that's my MVP.
Rob Lowe and Finn Delaney and Ty Webster are your leading scorers with 12 apiece. Nori on camera there, on screen. Ty Webster, great to see Ty Webster back. Playing for the Breakers, of course, when he was younger, before he went to Nebraska to play college basketball. Ty Webster was part of the Breakers setup. His older brother Corey, and Ty Webster, hasn't he matured into a point guard?
Oh, I'll tell you what, that game has grown up. For that young man, he has become an elite defender. Really utilizes his athleticism and length well there, but can score when he needs to. But he is a perfect point guard for what the Breakers need this season with the number of athletes and scorers they have.
Some great defensive point guards for the Tall Blacks as well in history, Mark Dickle, Paul Henare. Just pounding, and just to have somebody spearhead your defense like that with now Ty Webster for New Zealand and of course now the Breakers. It's a wonderful asset to have. And you might have heard they're playing the Jackson 5 again before they start the third quarter. We're about to get underway.
Find out. Traditions are forever. Can you feel it? And people standing up.
I honestly, 2020 has been a messed up year, right? But there are some things you would not see because of 2020, and that is David Seymour and Shane Young dancing. I mean, I've seen it all. I can die a happy man.
I'm glad some goals have been hit tonight. I'm glad you've become satisfied.
This really has to be an annual fixture for the Breakers. Good on Manuka Doctor as well for putting this on, helping the Breakers realize this dream, and congratulations to the Breakers for doing this as well. Surely now we can get this third quarter underway.
Players on the court. We've got the GMC trying to defend the inbounds pass.
That's right, he's the GM and the MC. And he's down as well. Back up. Jared Weeks gets us underway with Liam Messam up high. Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck on him. Spins and fades. Front of the rim, and Greg Murphy, can he track it down?
What a save!
Great work from Greg Murphy. Is Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck had it scored before he even grabbed it.
I think he lost the MVP right there. With the mental error, letting the ball go straight through the hands. Got to watch that fall into the hands.
Nori puts it up. Nick Mowbray gets that. Greg Murphy to Rob Lowe. Mowbray all the time, and it drops. Nick Mowbray. Another bucket for him. He is looking to shoot every time he gets the ball.
Yeah, he's got a little bit of the Corey Webster scoring machine in that game frame of his.
He has five. Jared Weeks gets Greg Murphy in the air, and Rob Lowe just easy as you like over Shane Young.
Don't get too cheeky, Rob. It could backfire.
Absolutely. Shane Young. Featherweight fighter in the UFC. Atlanta City Kickboxing, of course. Roger Tuivasa-Sheck. Can he get it in? Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck.
Let's go! That's what I'm putting.
Hyped. You got the stick-to-itiveness paying off there. The offensive rebound enabling him to get
through. Oh, they don't know what's going to happen here. Yo, Rump!
And Rob Lowe from deep. Easy on the glass.
Mowbray leaves it short. Liam Messam. Ooh. Turns the ball over.
15.
Running the point now. Tane Murray to his right. Gets that to drop over Jared Weeks.
Well, found some rhythm. Hits the first one. Now he's cooking with it. Yes.
Here's Weeks. Over his head to Liam Messam. Side of the backboard. Greg Murphy does well. Tane Murray couldn't quite track that down.
I got.
And that half court shot of Jared Weeks. Zoe Sadowski Sinner has a crack. Matt.
Why not? Give it a go.
Matt Walsh will personally put $10,000 into the account if no one else gets it. To Starship is Mowbray again. It's come out on fire.
Coming out hungry as we got here. Roger Tuivasa-Sheck. Talk a little smack.
Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck and Shane Young are talking. And Jared Weeks steps through and gets it up and in. Here comes Tuivasa-Sheck.
Come on, man.
Well, the facilitation has dropped down a level here in the third quarter. A lot of guys looking for the buckets.
Rob Lowe absolutely seagulling that.
Just smashing on chicks out there, Rob Lowe. Rob Lowe. Show some compassion.
Nori. Johnny just felt the full fury of Nori on that drive.
That could have been a flop, I'm not sure.
Oh, the look away. Mowbray can't get it to go down, though. Here's Liam Messam. Weeks. Jared Weeks. Left hand. English is good off the glass.
Showing the left. Ball handling skills. We see Greg Murphy off to the break. Oh, gets it down.
Greg Murphy, four Bathurst titles to his name.
Good on the straightaway. Used his speed to get the finish there.
Weeks for four. Just a reminder, $4,000 if a four-point shot is hit from the Manuka Doctor logos. Situated in midcourt. Just inside midcourt between the halfway and the three-point line.
And what do we got Courtney talking to right now?
I have got David Seymour with me. Now, David, I see you're sporting all the gear. You took on the other team. How did it feel out there?
Oh, absolutely fantastic, but a bit gutted at Benny. You know, I bought all their albums, and she's not giving me a fair play at all, marking me like a tiger.
Benny, and also Chloe as well, what was it like going up against each other on the court?
Oh, Chloe Swarbrick, look, I saw her play and I thought I can't possibly let Parliament down more, but I think I might have.
Well, you came straight off the plane from Wellington, straight onto the court. What was it like when the crowd were cheering for you when you got your shot in?
Oh, I tell you what, they're a lot more more aggressive here than in Parliament. That is, Parliament's a cakewalk compared to the intensity out there. These guys are playing to win, but Pink's going to take it home.
They sure are. What does the Pink need to do to take it home?
Oh, I think it's about getting the ball in the hoop, but I'm no expert. This is all new to me.
Well, thank you, David. Good luck for the second half.
Cheers. Thank you.
Good on you, David Seymour. Thanks, Court. Team Tom now only leads by three.
Oh, it's a nine.
Kai Borges with the block. No toys for you, Guy. Mowbray gets it back, though, and in. Nick Mowbray's had a third quarter. Chloe Swarbrick approves. Mowbray now has 9 points.
Timeout called. Team Tom has seen enough. Dan Shamir came out, wanted to stay humble. That's not what he's seen here in the third quarter. He is getting all upset. Got some free throws for charity about to happen now.
All right.
Brooke Roscoe from MyFM Afternoons.
All right. Why is Brooke can ball, though. He can play.
He's a former Tall Black teammate of mine. But he did say he was more nervous about the shoot free throws he's shooting in this one than ever before. Every free throw he makes is money to Starship.
Oh, that's good form. And Roger and Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck have been a highlight so far. Johnny here having a mixed bag so far, but he is entertaining as always.
Crashing, talking smack to everybody. Oh, look at that. Tried to take the flop. The officiating crew does not fall for it.
There you go. 10 free throws made by Brooke Roscoe from my drive. Well done. As much of Walters in the 660, guys. Look on from their baseline seats.
My FM home run representing in the Vlad Guerrero Jr. jersey.
That'd be great relief for him.
He was feeling the pressure. But 10 free throws is a great result for Starship.
Oh my God.
Back underway, Ty Webster with the ball. Kaikara. Kaikara, France for three. And Iron Van Dyke on the baseline couldn't grab it.
Give me the stat.
Maya Wilson. Screen set by Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck. Ty Webster strips it away.
Quick hands there. Coach Motomayor wants to see the foul. He's looking at me. He wants to know where the foul is.
Rob Lola's long. Tipped around. It's tight.
Yeah, I'm here.
Gives it up to Aaron Van Dyke. Silverfern legend gives it back. And Ty Webster, Julia obliges with a four.
From the honey pot. Another donation to Starship. Fantastic. See, 4-point cash total. You see, $8,000 raised already from the fours. That's fantastic.
It's Tom Abercrombie. He shoots for three. Rattles that in. Finn Delaney about to check in for his team.
Oh, the tide has turned. Team Tom back in the driver's seat. Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck shows the strength, flexing on everybody.
Kaikara France goes down. He's back up. Hard drive. No one mean mugs more than Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck.
His camera game is on point.
It is absolutely fire.
Much time the teams had to put in baseline out of bounds plays. You see some high execution here.
What are they going to run, Case?
Nah, he's the one who got fouled.
Top the sit down man. Screen, maybe?
I think just shoot, top it out to Ruby Tui up top, see if she can get a four-pointer.
Maybe up high to Ruby because it's a Meyer on the weak side there. Gives it back to Findelaini.
Oh my God.
Bounce pass to Carlos. Spencer misses.
Oh, Van Dijk
fires it to Kaikara France. He tracks it down. Carlos Spencer on him. Guy Williams barking for it.
Oh my God.
Now Guy Williams around Carlos Spencer.
But not the shooting touch.
Findelaini with the ball.
I do know that Guy Williams wants to dunk in this game more than pretty much anything.
A little bit of trouble for Carlos, but as always, uses some silky skills to get out of the trouble, and Findelaini rattles down to three. Quickly inbounded.
All created by the Carlos Spencer pass.
Let's go to Courtney, who's got 660 the band, minus Chris Mack with it. Or maybe she does have Chris Mack.
No, I don't have Chris Mack, Miles, but I've got 660 here with me. Guys, I need to know your thoughts on Chris's game so far.
Pretty terrible, really.
Did you guys give him any tips when you knew that he was going to be playing in this?
Sorry, say that again?
Did you give him any tips when you found out he was going to be playing?
Yesterday we went and all played a game of basketball as a band. And he played all right then. He stopped playing up to the standard he was yesterday. But look, the bright lights, the pressure.
Did you tell him maybe, or next time would some of you guys like to play instead?
Definitely not. No, thank you.
Well, yeah, I'll give it a go, eh? Next year, maybe.
There we go. Maybe some of the 660 members will play next year. And congratulations on the release of your new film as well.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Court. It'd be great to see the other members of 660 get a run as Maya Wilson gets the bucket.
I like the honesty on the game. Chris Mack getting it. Getting it from his teammates. So the Maya Wilson finish off some excellent offensive glass work out there by Team Finn.
Corey Webster.
Oh, what a pass. Oh.
Down goes Kaikara France.
Don't forget, once again, you can text Celeb Slam followed by your full name to 2838 to donate to the Starship Foundation.
Well, I tell you what, this wouldn't have been the first game for the Breakers after being in Europe for Ty Webster that he expected to be at Spark Arena. But what a game this has been. What a night this has been as Carlos Spencer finds Maya Wilson. Maya Wilson finds Ty Webster, who's on the other team. Ty from half court, a little strong. His brother has it, though. Now Corey Webster surveys his options. Findelaini misses that four-point attempt. Van Dijk fires
a chance.
Watch out for Carlos Spencer.
Oh, hammered.
Absolutely hammered by Carlos Spencer. Nobody can talk more than Guy Williams and Carlos Spencer. Now it's all on Findelaini and Ty Webster.
He's dirty. He's dirty.
Guy Williams screaming that Carlos is dirty. Not a lot of arms in that tackle from Carlos.
Hey, if you're going to go for it on the break, you've got to deal with the consequences there, Guy Williams. As you see, he's trying to line up for the dunk here, and here comes Carlos Spencer. Not even that bad of a foul. Guy Williams gave up on the play. I think he had some fear.
Guy Williams at the line. Big changes coming in for Team Tom. Roger Tuivasa-Sheck is back on the floor. Jenny May Coffin, after that four-point shot in the first half, is back out there. Chris Johnson, who's in the country, he's been having some runs with the Breakers. He's a former NBA player.
I just saw Guy Williams kiss the ball. I don't think that's following COVID protocols.
No, don't kiss the ball. Speaking of which, how lucky are we to have events like this in New Zealand? Level one ain't so bad.
Yeah, I don't know if luck has as much to do with it as great protocols. Well done. Well done on trying to get rid of it.
Give yourself a pat on the back, New Zealand. Maya Wilson, long two. Johnson with the rebound. Ruby Tui hounding J.A. Here's pass the check. Roger, that is. Rivetui has options. Corey Webster thought about the four. Gives it to Delaney. Can't bank it in. Roger Tui Vasashek now.
They've got to find Jenny Mae Clarkson outside. Ty Webster now from deep. What's he going to do with it?
It's a jab step on Carlos Spencer. Johnson taps it. And RTS can't save it. Modi Moir is barking at Finn Delaney. He's coaching the life out of this game. It's Modi Moir, Breakers assistant coach. Dan Shamir, a little bit more subdued, but that's why those two work for the Breakers. Look away from Delaney. Rivetui. Back to Carlos. Chris Mack. And Carlos goes down. Chris Mack with a massive charge on him.
Well sold. Well sold there. Took the contact. Delayed reaction on the sniper taking him to the ground. But earns the call anyway. That's the way to sell it. That's the way to really sell a foul in a celebrity game.
Carlos Spencer selling it beautifully. Chris Mack teeing up Rivetui now. Chris Mack is all about defense.
Oh, shot clock violation.
That is the end of the third quarter.
Oh, never mind.
And that'll be us. 64-60. Team Tom leads Team Finn. And we have mascots on the floor.
Watch out. I don't know. I'm going to go with the giraffe. I don't know what they're doing, but I'm going with the giraffe because I like tall things. Mascot races.
Well, we've got Captain Starship.
I mean, Captain Starship has a jetpack. He should be fast. I'm going with Harold. Harold's tall.
Harold the giraffe. We've got a lady in a house. And we've got the Warriors.
Vodafone Warrior.
The mighty Vodafone Warriors mascot.
We've got the Duplo guy. Spider-Man.
Is that a Marvel Ascension uniform?
Mr.
And we've got
Potato.
A potato.
Oh, they're running suicides.
Suicides.
Oh, my.
Holy heck. Cheeky Nakia leading out. Captain Starship. Can he find some boosters? Cheeky Nakia leading out from the Warriors mascot. The Potato's lagging behind. He's roasted. The Giraffe Harold has lost his mind. Captain Starship. No, it's going to be between Cheeky Nakia and...
We got a race.
And the Warriors mascot.
Oh, and he's coming up
that
at the
cheeky.
End.
Cheeky. Here come the Warriors. And the Warriors. Win. The mascot race.
I don't know what my eyes just saw, but I guess they enjoyed it.
Absolutely loved it. Captain Starship is absolutely, he's absolutely stuffed. I mean, that's a big helmet.
That's a lot of costume.
That's a lot of costume to go on. Spidey. I was disappointed in Spider-Man, to be honest. Didn't use his Spidey senses that well in that race.
Yeah.
Harold, I don't know why Harold's celebrating. He's just a great team player, is Harold.
He's just happy.
And the lady in the house, middle of the road. That's where she finished, I mean, middle of the pack.
Cheeky's still out there just doing some sit-ups. There's the Team Finn on looking. Finn wants to know why he's on TV. Why is his camera still on? Are you still there?
It's okay, Finn. We won't bite. Johnson, Mack, Seymour, RTS, and Ty Webster out there for Team Tom. Corey Webster, Low, Tui, maybe Carlos Spencer. We're just going to go 3-on-5, are we?
I feel like as the game goes on, the fatigue setting in, and everybody's like, maybe I don't want to play.
Chloe Swarbrick's back out there. We need two more on Team Finn. Eric Murray back out there, two-time Olympic gold medalist. And Maya Wilson completes the five for Finn Delaney's team. Straight into it is Corey Webster with a four-point shot. And Ty Webster can't control it.
Is C-Web over on the four-pointer today?
going to say yes.
Here comes Corey Webster. That is his brother Ty. Eric Murray for three. Eric Murray nails it.
Let's throw it over to Courtney. Who's she got over there in the corner?
Right, I'm here with Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck, James McCroney. There's only 2 points in it. What do you guys need to do to take this one home?
Hard D. Very hard D.
We love hard D. But the other thing is that Johnny has come back big time. If you saw his first half.
We saw it.
Did you see it? What happened? We don't know. But we went in, we put him under hypnosis. He's come out a different man. I mean, he was trying to copy LeBron. On. He's trying to just be Johnny Tuivasa-Sheck. That's all we're asking. That's all we're asking.
Roger's on. Get me on, man.
What do you need to do to get Roger out of the game? You know, any tactics there?
Get in his head. Once he's in his head, he's going to be throwing ugly-ass shots like he is already, to be honest.
Accidentally tackle him or something, Jake?
Yeah, I mean, we've already got our eyes on Seymour right now. He is a massive problem out there. We took Ruby off and said, no, we can't have her face him because she was almost the first victim of his end-of-life bill in training.
Hey, focus on the game.
Focus on the game.
Oh, good. Okay, I'll let the guys focus on the game. Good luck for the rest of the
Thanks.
Thanks, Courtney. Thank you to Johnny and James. Maya misses that.
Oh, David Seymour with a stiff arm shoving Corey Webster out of the way.
Chloe Swarbrick. Oh, Ty Webster! Gives us a razzle-dazzle. Oh. Man, he threw that down.
The athlete. Looks so smooth when he's up in the air.
Rob Lokan at the four. Chris Johnson. Showing his pedigree. Nice pass to RTS. It gets the bucket.
Beautiful break run there as we see Ty Webster on the break.
Oh, my.
High above the rim, cocking it back.
Is Rob Lowe, who stuffs himself on the rim.
Poor Rob Lowe.
Poor Rob. David Seymour running the lane. Chris Johnson, though, couldn't see him. Ironically, too far to the left of him. And here's Rob Lowe.
Oh, dime. Forrest Warwick, get it in. Oh, good look. Oh,
there's
look.
A foul.
Foul call. Heading for the line.
You're up, Chloe.
Chloe has to shoot free throws, and she's not particularly happy about it.
She's like, is this the free throw line? Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
I don't blame it. It's pretty hard to spot in that Burger King logo.
That's okay. Let her get a little bit closer. It's all friendly here today. Oh, a 10-pointer.
We got a 10-point, 3-point. Free throw to go right here.
Gotta say.
All the pressure's now on Chloe.
No pressure. No pressure. Ooh. Just a bit short. One more try. One more try. Just a little bit more arc. Let's see what she got. Anybody got some...
A little bit more on the knees.
This looks unofficial.
Not a lot about this game is official, Case.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Rob Lowe playing hard through the rebound, though.
Corey has it. Ty is on him. Swarbrick just recently
Good
at
looks.
That same spot. Chris
Good
Mack.
Looks, though.
Chris Mack.
What's he got? Can he redeem himself in the eyes of his bandmates? He cannot.
I think he is actually 6 for 60 in this game.
Oh, I see what you did there.
Julian Savier. David Seymour all over him.
And David Seymour doing exactly what a politician should do. Fouls and then denies it completely.
Big changes for Team Tom. Zoe Sadowski-Sinnott, Cara France, Liam Messon, Notley, and Jared Weeks out there.
How are we doing?
Oh, that is cynical from Rob Lowe. Ruby Tully is actually the only one in foul trouble in this game. She's got two. Kai Car France.
Oh, good effort, good effort.
Throwing a right hand like he does in the octagon.
And there's 100% of the shots you don't take.
100% correct.
Eric Murray, Liam deep.
Oh, Eric Murray. Liam Messam and Julian Savvy are having words. It's getting physical. Here's Lowe.
Yeah, Stephen, you never want to match the rugby players up against each other.
Cara France has it. Between Eric Murray's legs. Kai Cara. France gets a strip. Here's Rob Lowe.
Rob Lowe out there bullying little guys again.
Turnover. Zoe Sadowski-Sinnott fires it out of bounds. Did it come off Julian Savir? It did. Now we've got a timeout, so let's go to Courtney Taiti again.
Yes, we're back again. I've got Guy Williams. He's on fire. Irene Van Dyke. Guy, how is it out there?
Carlos Spencer fouled me. He's a cheater and a coward because he knew I was going to dunk on him.
Is that how you saw it, Ice?
Well, let's just say we've got this. We've got this in the bag. It's all day.
You've got faith. Now, who do you see as the MVP? Because a lot of people are saying David Seymour's been quite good for you guys.
100%, without a doubt, hands down. That man would make anyone fly.
She's lying. Seymour's been trash. He's on my team, and I'm going to say that right now. Roger Tuivasa-Sheck is the MVP today.
All right, I'm going to let you two battle it out. I'm out of here.
Good luck with that one, Courtney. I like the honesty from Guy Williams, calling out his teammates as trash. Solid smack talk to your own team, David Seymour. Looks like he just heard that comment from Guy Williams and was affected deeply by it.
6:11 to go in this game, and it's Team Tom with a 7-point lead over Team Finn. Finn starts to tone it up here for Moti Moa. And Team Finn, just beat the W a little bit.
What is going to go on? We got the 6-point difference here. We got the 4-pointers coming into play. I feel some guys are going to start really looking for that half-court shot as well. Everybody's thirsty to get that 10. Beautiful.
Julian Salvia with a block.
That was beautiful.
Julian Salvia strips Liam Messam. Here it is. All black on all black. And Julian Salvia just a little strong on that one. Here comes Jared Weeks. Jared Weeks gets Rob Lowe up in the air, but he can't find anyone to pass it to. Cara France for three. Almost banked it in. Savia with the rebound. Weeks with the steal. Weeks for four. Is it good? Webster up ahead to Rob Lowe. Here comes Rob Lowe with a smile.
Rob Lowe was seagulling for about three possessions in a row there, so finally got and took advantage of it.
Rob Lowe has been a massive hungus in this game. I'm just putting it out there.
He's been a hungus.
A huge hungus. He's got 20 points.
My two biggest hunguses in this game are Rob Lowe and Nick Mowbray.
I'm sorry, but there is a time and a place for Darude, and it's not now.
No, it's actually brought the crowd down. First time ever. Except for these two. These three are loving it. And see, that's not genuine.
Delaney with a dunk. And he tells Jared Weeks all about it.
Jared Weeks is still talking about the other shots that have been coming from Delaney's way.
Lead is only two now for Team Tom. Weeks with the ball. Weeks for three. Lowe tips it. Zoe has it up in the air, and Finn Delaney got that rebound from Liam Messam. He just brushed it off. Delaney brings it up. Hesitation. And Delaney with the dunk ties it up at 72.
And Shamir's seen enough. He wants a timeout. It's suddenly gotten serious.
There it is.
Even if the players are having fun, I guarantee Dan Shamir and Moti Moa both want to beat each other. As we see, Finn Delaney with a crossover, brings it down, flushes it with ease.
showing that beautiful skill set that has seen him really take huge steps forward in the last couple of years of his career. Chloe Swarbrick, let them know about it.
This is why Chloe Swarbrick is a leader. Guy Williams still searching for his dunk. Another series of New Zealand Today in the pipeline as well. Nori and Tom Abercrombie, it's all on the line. You can vote for the MVP on the gram. The Breakers NZ is the handle. Let them know who you think should be the MVP of the Manuka Doctor All-Star Celeb Slam at Spark Arena.
We will be tabulating and keeping track and speaking to the MVP after the game.
Sure.
Well, when I say we, I mean the royal sense. Someone on Breakers Instagram is going to count them up.
Ruby Tui with the ball. JTS gives it back to Delaney. Floater game is good from Finn Delaney.
Tim Finn takes its first lead in a long, long time.
Let's get Tim Finn next year.
Ready with the foul.
Not a foul at half court. Ruby Tui, I love the fact she plays both ends of the floor.
She is locked in. She is not taking it lightly.
That's why she was the 2019 Rugby Women's Sevens Player of the Year. A complete player. Now, Finn Delaney is all about winning. You can tell. Look at him run the floor. Carlos Spencer tried to put it up for him. Johnny Tui Vasashek almost met him at the rim.
Oh, dime Ruby Tui.
JTS let Shane Young know about it.
What a connection there. Ruby Tui with the assist.
Abercrombie ties it up at four from the honey pot.
Another donation to Starship with the four-pointer made from the honey pot. $9,000 now on the ninth floor.
Delaney answers with a four of his own.
Make that $10,000 to Starship. Finn Delaney's D's getting up there now. He's not going to let Tom Abercrombie have it.
Nori driving, puts it up.
Oh, good luck though. Look at the effort by Team Tom around the basket.
Look at the hustle. Ruby Tui on the floor. Johnny Tui Vasashek, hounded by Guy Williams, gives it to Delaney. Gives it around Shane Young's head. Williams grabs the board.
Solid basketball, but Team Tom's had a chance to come back and cut back into this four-point lead.
Ruby Tui. Ruby Tui is all about it right now. Nori for four.
Oh,
a little strong.
I like the confidence, though.
Johnny Tui Vasashek breaks free from Shane Young. Head him up against the cage. Guy Williams puts the D on him. Carlos Spencer. Jay Mays fouled by Ruby Tui.
On the sideline.
Oh, no, she defends. She defends her right out.
Ruby Tui from three to extend the lead. It was good for him.
So 80 to 76, 2 minutes flat to go in the game.
This is money time here. David Seymour back on the court.
David Seymour.
That is coming from David Seymour. I see it happening.
Running away with it like he did with Ipsum.
She got the block on the break, got called for a foul. She's not happy about it. She's not going to let him have any of his looks.
Which club should we go to next, Case? Finn Delaney pulls down that board. Team Finn is up four. Start a set from Carlos Spencer.
Oh, it was pretty. It was a pretty move.
an unlikely rivalry is born between Guy Williams and Carlos Spencer. David Seymour. Lost the handle. He's down.
The effort is fantastic.
Shane Young. Team Finn up ahead. Tom. Tom's going to block a shot.
Piece.
Nick Mowbray traveled.
Foul call.
Oh, foul call.
Foul call to Jimmy Nate Clarkson.
We need a 4-point.
Chance for Team Finn to extend this 4-point lead with just 1:14 left. We heard Team Tom talking about it. They need a 4-pointer. They also need a free throw miss here.
All the drama coming to the pointy end of this game.
I know what everybody's thinking.
Yeah?
We just need more overtime. Let's get some overtime. Bonus basketball.
What a great idea. Mowbray misses the second. Shane Young. Look at
David
Seymour. What is going on?
The whistle's blowing. Nobody's listening.
No one can hear a thing. It's so loud. We've had Nick Mowbray from Zuru, David Seymour, Shane Young, all five for a basketball at Spark Arena. And Modi Mawai wants the sportsman-like foul.
Look at the effort. Diving in. Doesn't care about knees.
Look at this.
He doesn't care about the knee. He wants the ball.
Look at this.
And now he's grabbing it with his feet. Hyped. An unlikely friendship occurred.
Shane Young and David Seymour, they've got each other's backs.
Who would have thought that coming into the day? It's going to take a couple of towels to wipe up that sweat pile. I think it was Team Tom looking nervous out there. Not sure how they're going to get it.
I better pick up my dart.
For what it's worth, my MVP is Ruby Tui. Tom Abercrombie can't make it. Williams back to Tom. Kai Kara. All 5-5.
Clarkson for
Jenny,
four.
Jenny May. So we have 45.8 seconds to go, and the lead is still four for Finn Delaney's team.
Looking for solid.
Will it be
here.
Six? It certainly will be. Timeout call. 82-76. Modi Mawai. Call timeout.
Well, we do have the 4-pointers in play. As Team Finn has gone up 6 points here, but. Who's Coach Dan Shamir going to go to? Director of basketball for Team Tom.
This is
the
full time. You lean body. Yeah? Okay?
So 10 points.
David is here. Okay? You're setting a screen. I'm not sure you know what it is. But you go this way and you set the screen 4 times.
Yeah.
Okay? And who else we got? We got Danny, right? So Danny, you'll be here. And
guy,
you'll be on this side.
Please! Hey! 1, 2, 3!
Like your screen. Danny screen through you, running off the screen, you catch, and you shoot it.
Okay.
That's a complex play.
Alright, now I can do this.
So you're spinning, Kai goes this way, you guys go set the screen, get him open, Tom will make the pass, don't worry. Right here, 3-point shot.
Team on right. Three! David on three! 1, 2, 3,
here we go, 82-76. What do Team Tom have in their plans? Well, the youth have voted, and the MVP of the Manuka Doctor All-Star Celeb Slam is Benny.
Oh, I like it.
I like it a lot.
I think it's the effort. The effort and the enthusiasm is what brought that MVP vote.
Maya Wilson with the steal. Wilson.
Finn Delaney cleans it up.
Is Finn Delaney a hungus now?
He wants the W. Oh, look at that.
Oh, it's not over.
Cara France rips it from Greg Murphy. It's Tom Abercrombie looking for a four-pointer. Hounded by Nick Mowbray. Williams has it. Finn Delaney all over him. And Ben Williams throws it away.
No foul called.
Modi Moana wants a sub. So they're going to let him get the subs in.
With ball's coming back, inbounding it. You receive, there's the MVP. Not Rob Lowe. You are not the MVP. You were the Hungus MVP.
There's my MVP, James McConey. Ruby Tilly. She's looking for some advice.
Right now.
Modi Moa.
Well, there's only 17 seconds left, but there's discussions at the scores bench about what's going on.
Let's go, Blue!
We've got a foul call.
You're a liar!
We're going to go shots.
Shots? Who's shooting?
Who is shooting?
What is going on?
No. Whoever got fouled. I think it's
18. Team Finn is heading to the free throw line.
So after some deliberation, Nick Mowbray will shoot two.
Booyah!
I think he got thrown off there. Guy Williams, let him know about the miss. He's feeling tight. Nick Mowbray feeling tight on the free throw line. Don't know if this one's going to go.
He's 1-for-7 now. And he fouls Tom Abercrombie.
Tom Abercrombie fouled. Not in the bonus yet. Here's Team Finn. Still another foul to get. No. Free throws.
Yeah, we're shooting free throws.
David Seymour is headed to the line, even though Thomas Abercrombie fouled.
Oh, now we've got the 10-point zone coming out again. Can David Seymour
for victory
put Team Tom back up in front? Corey Webster can't believe it.
It's a 10-point shot.
Modi Moa wants a timeout.
On the make, he wants a timeout. Can David Seymour redeem this jump shot?
This is huge.
A free throw?
Team Finn needs a four-point shot, 15 seconds to go. Who is going to take it? I'm Lowe if he's in the game.
We got Rob Lowe. Rob Lowe's in. Findellini's in. Louis Swarbrick.
And Ruby Tui.
Julian Sevilla. Who's, let's see who's inbounding. Rob Lowe looks like he's going to be inbounding. Not a lot of time left. Big one here.
Is Rob Lowe into inbound it.
Oh, great. Findellini
in rhythm. Oh, Findellini can't make it. Turnover.
Almost. Team Finn gets it back.
They're all over.
David Seymour again. Loves a pile on.
Absolutely manic out there at the moment. What is the call?
Free throws?
Free throws? How about make the first, miss the second, kick it out for a three, tie the game.
We're going to get a little break as the Moffitts get out there and take care of some of the sweat from David Seymour once again, diving on the floor.
Here we go, Ruby Tui at the line. Bounce the first.
Well, now you wanna miss the second now. Get the offensive rebound. Chuck it out for that four-pointer. Get the win.
Rob to tip it out to Finn. Can she miss it? She does. Rob to Finn for the win. Findellini can't get it.
Still a second left.
Ruby Tui, this won't count. And that is the game at Spark Arena. Down to the end, it fell. Team Tom comes away with a three-point win. 86-83. Your MVP is Benny. But really, basketball was the winner on the day.
Basketball was the big winner.
And Starship Hospital.
There's the real big winner, though. A great cause. You can tell everybody.